All right, we have a few more people still joining in. And I think few of you have already seen the slideshow roll that gives you some good information about Tarrant Area Food Bank. But just to get the program kickstarted, we are going to be dynamic today. So Julie, be patient with me. I'm going to get the ball rolling, get the energy going. I see Mike has joined. I see Sri has joined. Fantastic. This is great. And in interest of time, let's go ahead and get started. So folks, good morning. Thank you very much for joining today's session. This is the first time we have ever done this thing. Those of you who do not know what HungerMitao is, let me just explain those two words combined together. HungerMitao means wipe out hunger. It's an initiative, a movement that was started by a group of passionate Indian American community folks who believe that wherever they live, they want to make sure that nobody goes hungry. So with that intent, with that spirit, about 4 years ago, they launched this thing. Co-founder of HungerMitao, Anna Asawa, will talk to you a little bit more about that in the very near future, in a half an hour. But today, I just wanted to say how appreciative we are that you all accommodated our pivot. Initially, our goal was to have a volunteer session and meet and greet with the executives of the food bank, volunteers of the food bank. We had a whole evening, whole morning planned to do all of that. But darn Delta, we had to pivot, and pivot we did. So here we are, and we had no idea who will show up, who will not show up. But that's okay. The show must go on. That is the spirit with which we are launching the HungerMitao at Tarrant Area Food Bank today. Again, once again, thank you very much for all of you joining in. A few ground rules. Please stick around. My mess up in the beginning of not showing you the Bollywood dance, I'll catch up to that. You will enjoy some of the Bollywood dances, some wonderful singing. Actually, I have a medley of Bollywood songs from 70s till now by young local performers. You will really enjoy listening to that. But more importantly, you'll enjoy listening to the CEO and president of the food bank, Julie Butner. You'll enjoy listening to the co-founder of HungerMitao, Anna Asawa. You'll enjoy listening to my good friend, Stephen. He'll talk about cricket more than he'll talk about the food bank, but that's all right. We need some of that change. You'll enjoy listening to our passionate co-chair for HungerMitao at Tarrant Area, Ritu Raju. And you'll enjoy listening to Lisa, who is like, I cannot thank her enough. She has been the anchor. She has been the quarterback, keeping us all organized and moving forward. So we'll have few conversations with them. So they are not really speeches, they are more conversation, right? I have set it up such a way that you can unmute yourself if you need to. It's a small enough group here, feel free to do so. But if you're not speaking, I would request you to keep it muted so it doesn't disturb the speaker. Now, the ground rules, as I said earlier, please be active on the chat session. You know, feel free to reflect, you know, share your comments. If you have a question, please post it there. All right. So with that, without any further delay, I am going to invite Julie Butner of Tarrant Area Food Bank. She is the CEO and president there. I have not had the opportunity to meet with her again because of the COVID and then the following Delta virus. We were not able to go there in person, but can't wait till the first opportunity we get there to go there and meet with her. We have had conversation over Zoom, and I cannot imagine a better leader to lead the Tarrant Area Food Bank than her. So as you start your remarks, I will go ahead and get your PowerPoint slides up. Is that okay, Julie?
Yes. Thank you for such a warm welcome this morning, Raj. I really, really appreciate it. And I'm really also very thankful that you are not asking me to do the Bollywood dance. It could be quite scary. As Stephen knows, I'm not a very good dancer or singer. They have tried to get me to sing here too. But thank you all so much for joining on this Saturday morning. And we are so disappointed that this COVID virus is yet again interrupting the good work of the community and all the work that the community does to support Tierran Area Food Bank. We so wanted to host you here at the facilities. And I know we will get an opportunity to do that in the near future, but I think it was absolutely the right call given the new surge that we're having in the community to do this virtually instead of in person. So I'll walk through these slides, Raj, and I'll just ask you if you can move to slide 3, that would be great.
Great.
Here at Tarrant Area Food Bank, we have a mission of empowering communities to alleviate hunger by providing food education and resources. We know that hunger is a crisis, and people always have crisis in their life, whether they've lost a job or lost a loved one, or something has changed in their personal predicament that causes them to be in crisis. And so we know that there is always going to be a need for a safety net like Tarrant Area Food Bank in the community to help those who are in crisis. Next slide. We represent 13 counties here at Tarrant Area Food Bank. Many people do not know that. They think that we only serve Tarrant County, and that is not the case. We have 13 counties. We divide the DFW Metroplex with our sister food bank in Plano, Texas, North Texas Food Bank. They serve the east side. We serve the west side right along the I-35 corridor. In these 13 counties, we have roughly 2.9 million people. And of the 2.9 million people, 500,000 are food insecure each and every day. And that number just gets larger as the community grows. So anytime you have population growth because of jobs or opportunity, you have some set of the population that are working in jobs that do not provide a living wage, or some subset of the population that is experiencing crisis. And so as the population grows, there is a direct correlation to the number of people who are food insecure growing as well. This is our service area. Again, Tarrant Area Food Bank, we are on the west side of I-35, covering 13 counties and over 500,000 people who are food insecure. Next slide, please. Tarrant Area Food Bank is affiliated with several organizations. We have an agreement with Feeding America, which you may have heard of. This is the national organization. There are over 200 food banks that are part of Feeding America. It's a contractual agreement. It's an industry association. By being a member of Feeding America, we have access to the United States Department of Agriculture Food and also the Texas Department of Agriculture Food, which has been a tremendous blessing during the pandemic. This is just very high quality food for the organization. These are some of the hunger statistics in the community. 1 in 6 people struggle with hunger. $10 will provide 50 meals. $1 provides 5 meals for members of the community. And of the 500,000 that I mentioned that are food insecure in our service area, 25% are children. Next slide, please. I'm not sure how many might be familiar with the Alice Report. This is put out by the United Way every 2 years, and it looks at who we serve. And it's a common misnomer. People think that the food bank is here for those who are just really down and out and unemployed and homeless. And that is not the case. The majority of the community members who come for our services are actually working. They are the working poor. So they are asset limited, income constrained, and employed. And we saw this absolutely more frequently during the pandemic. Folks who work two or three jobs, the single mom who has kids at home and is working two or three jobs just to put food on the table and to pay those basic bills such as rent, utility, food and gasoline, not having enough money to cover it all. And so this ALIS report tells us that in Tarrant area, you need $16 an hour, $16 an hour for a living wage to cover four things: rent, utilities, gasoline, and food, just those four things. It does not include clothes. It does not include pharmaceuticals or other needs that you might have. It's just those four items. So you can imagine, think of all the hospitality jobs or service jobs that we have that do not pay $16 an hour. So those folks are either having to work second and third jobs, or they're in some sort of crisis and they need support from organizations such as Tarrant Area Food Bank. Next slide, please. We served at the end of fiscal year 2020, which would have been last October, a million nutritious meals and did 52 million pounds of food distributed into this community. We are about to wrap up our fiscal year one more month, and we will hit 70 million pounds of food going into the community. We do this through over 350 partner agencies. This is churches, Boys and Girls Clubs, schools, hospitals. We also do direct to client distribution, which we have never done before, but the pandemic forced us to do it because we needed to put so much more food out into the community. We also have a home meal delivery program, if you could go back. And we also use school pantries and healthcare food pantries to get those million meals out. Next slide, please. This is, again, the service area, those 13 counties, by the type of customer that we support or client we support. Next slide. COVID-19, I just want to touch on this briefly. If you could go to slide 11, Raj. We saw this, you read about this, you saw it on the news. Unemployment increased, it caused a huge increase in need. With all the shelter in place restrictions, we were not allowed to have our volunteers at the volunteer center. Many of our partner agencies closed down because of the high risk for over 65 population. All of these things had a tremendous impact on our ability to serve food or deliver food in the old method. And so we really had to change our delivery model. We formed lots of new partnerships. I'm very proud of the work we have done with Meals on Wheels, Catholic Charities, United Way, just to name a few. Next slide. To this day, so I mean, we often say here that food security lags economic recovery. And so as we're coming out of the impacts of COVID and really still living through the impacts of COVID, Tarrant Area Food Bank still is experiencing volunteer shortages. We are now asking that all of our volunteers be vaccinated if they're serving us inside of a building. Higher than normal unfunded operating costs, because we don't have the volunteers, we're having to hire more labor to do the work that the volunteers previously did. The food source and supply chain is very unstable. And so we have highs and lows in terms of our ability to source the right type of food. The lack of distribution partners that I mentioned, you know, many of these partner agencies were closed when all the schools closed down. We have over 50 schools that we partner with to distribute food. And when the schools closed, we lost those distribution partners. And then just continuing to look for funding that will help support this higher than usual demand that is just not going away. We're 18 months into the pandemic and continuing to serve at 40 and 50% higher rates than we did pre-pandemic. Next slide, please. So by the numbers, we've seen a 60% increase in the need of food. The pounds that we distributed in FY20 was 52 million in our service area. We gave 8 million to other struggling food banks, over 1 million meals. These numbers are going up. We're going to see the end of September where that 60 million is 70 million in our service area alone. So this, the need is just continuing to be high. Next slide. We are very excited about two services that are new to us that we're starting in response to this continued need in the community. One is a satellite facility that is located in Parker County. It is 30,000 square feet of distribution center and will also offer many of our programmatic solutions. It is scheduled to open the 1st of October and it will serve about 20% of our service area and about half of the counties, but these are all of the rural counties that have less dense population. It's also exciting because by freeing up the space here at our main facility in Fort Worth and reallocating it over to Ternary Food Bank West, it will allow us to provide a better service right here in Tarrant County where we have the highest population in need. And then on the bottom, we're super excited about this. I hope you guys can come out and take a look at it when things kind of, the surge kind of dissipates a little bit, but we have two new red buses, resources and education delivered. One is dedicated to Fort Worth and one is dedicated to Arlington. And this will provide access to many community resources such as SNAP, Medicaid, CHIP, and the Texas Women's Health Program. So we're super excited about this. We have one on the ground already. It's been operating for about a month and we've seen a 28% increase in SNAP enrollment. And that is so important because for every one meal we can provide, SNAP provides nine. We're also providing nutrition education and emergency food on the Big Red Bus. So look for that, the Big Red Bus.
All right. And I would like to take a minute and just quickly reflect on some of the key points that Julie has brought up. I won't repeat things, but I will simply say, folks, you know, last year in the heart of the pandemic, our living rooms, our family rooms were invaded by news about hunger all across the country, frankly, all across the world. We saw the long lines of cars and people waiting to collect a box of food. Lives were displaced, lives were turned upside down. Thank goodness for food banks, for pivoting, for stepping up, especially during that time. As you all know, the retail industry for all practical purposes was shut down, right? And thousands of people just did not know where to turn. But they knew that at least for that one basic necessity, they could count on the food bank. And food banks, and we have, both Anna and I have worked with several food banks and Feeding America. I will just say one thing, which is what they had planned to get to by 2025, the number of meals they were hoping to provide by then, they provided last year. Mm-hmm. I mean, that was just shocking. The need was that high. I mean, it was people like people across the street, people next door to you, no fault of theirs, were just out on this, I mean, literally displaced. So if I had a hat, I would take my hat off right now to you, Julie, and all the food bankers. Thank you. You know, you are frontline workers who may not be appreciated as much, but sincerely, we working with Feeding America and the food bank know how difficult it is for you all, how challenging it is for you all, how risky it is for you all, and how yet every day, right, you have been creative to bring National Guards to come in and help you during volunteering when volunteers were not available, right? Mm-hmm. So it is just fantastic. And I think I bring it up because food bank cannot do it alone. Community needs to play a very, very important role. Mm-hmm. And I'm very proud that HungerMitao has stepped up and you know, filled some gap. But before we talk about HungerMitao, I have to bring in my friend, Steven. Now, I have known Steven for at least 3-4 years now. but I still keep confused how to pronounce his name. He spells it S-T-E-P-H-E-N. So being fanatic, I just kind of say Stephen, and my wife keeps saying, no, it's Stephen. I said, then why doesn't he spell it S-T-E-V-E-N? But nevertheless, I can always pull his leg because he's a cricketer and I'm a cricketer. So without further delay, Stephen is with the Tarrant Area Food Bank. We have known him the longest at that food bank, and he has always been focused on when can we get HungerMitao launched at Tarrant Area Food Bank. It's his vision, his drive, why we are here today. So Stephen, without further delay, my friend, over to you.
Well, thank you very much, Raj, and to everyone, happy Independence Day. And that's an especially audacious one, auspicious one this year, because we're finally getting HungerMitao off the ground. Before I go on, I would like to point out something about Julie that many of you probably don't know, and that she'd only been with us about 6 weeks before the pandemic hit. Didn't know much about food banks other than she had a drive to be part of one, and that hunger has always been her cause. So she was just looking around the food bank thinking, who are all these crazy people and what will I do with them? And then the greatest crisis and challenge in the food bank history struck. And through her leadership, we did not just cope, but we thrived. And as you saw some of the numbers earlier, had just record level of service and participation, and not just the food banks. Most difficult time, but the countries and of course the world at large. So thank you very much for your leadership over the last year and a half, Julie. We would not be here without her. I met Anna Salva about 4 years ago. Now in food banking, distributing 1 million meals is not by any means an easy task. It's very complex. At the food bank, we're just 140 employees. And 140 people cannot distribute 70 million pounds of food a year. We rely on 25,000 volunteers each year, 50,000 different donors, and just a remarkable and diverse array of stakeholders that keep everything in orbit and keep us and help us work together to helping so many hungry families. So to do that, we're always on the lookout for new corporations and groups that can come in and be partners, volunteering, and also very importantly, financial supporters. And every now and then we get lucky and one absolutely brilliant one just knocks on our door. And that's what happened in Fort Worth about 4 years ago. And standing on the other side of that door was Raj and Anna, and we sat down and they began to lay out this audacious plan to unite the entire Indian diaspora. Right? Anna, everyone? She said, yes, every Indian American is going to join this movement. And quickly, my thinking turned from audacious to absolutely brilliant. And it was the audacity that helped attract me to the concept and made me believe it would succeed. Now, they had just finished opening it at the North Texas Food Bank, and they were going to go to Houston next. And I definitely wanted to be a part of it. Anna's passion is just contagious. I had to be part of it. And also my family has a long connection with India. A couple of generations that had worked in India as civil servants. And so India has always been near and dear to my heart. So I thought, not only could we join this movement and bring in this educated and prosperous and compassionate group of Americans in service to the hungry, but my head just danced with all the visions of Indian culture that we could bring into the food bank. So we would be playing cricket in the distribution center. In the break room, there would be unending samosas and butter chicken. Our volunteers would be so happy processing all the food that, you know, they break out into song and dance numbers every hour. And it would just be heaven. Maybe we could even script a Bollywood movie around the food bank. But Anna is very sensible as well as being passionate. And she knew along with us, we could not start this without laying a foundation that would ensure success. We did not want people to be excited for a couple of months and then become interested in something else, lose interest in food banking. We wanted to design a program that was here for the long haul. So COVID became a setback just as we started to form concrete plans to gain some momentum and get the program off the ground. But it was also very important to have a local champion, someone in and of the Tarrant County community. And Anna brought that person to us. Her name is Rita Raju, and you'll meet her in a few minutes. But it's been a joy to, over a very long 48 months or so, to develop plans for this project. But this is just a remarkably happy and brilliant day that we can get this off the ground and that you're all part of it. So without any further ado, I will turn it over to our leader, Anna Asada.
Jeez. Wow. Thank you so much.
Anna, it's all yours.
Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Julie. Thank you, Ritu. Thank you, everybody who's joined today. So I don't have a long speech or anything, but Raj, will you get the presentation?
Yeah, I'll get the presentation.
I have three slides I'm going to speak to.
Main, right? Mm-hmm. Bear with us.
There you go. Can you guys see this? Perfect.
In case you missed Stephen's picture, here it is. All right.
Thank you, Raj. So what is HungerMitao? And Raj said HungerMitao is a mashup of two words, one Indian, one English. Hunger is hunger, Mitao is wipe out. So the audacious goal is to wipe out hunger. It's totally volunteer driven. The intention is to create awareness about hunger in the Indian American community. We chose the Indian American community because both Raj and I are from India, and this is the community where we wield the most influence. So we wanted to make sure that this program works in one discrete community, and then of course we can share. So it's all about improving the community engagement as well channeling resources. We launched 4 years ago at North Texas Food Bank. It's not an organization. HungerMitao is not a 501c3. Nobody makes donations to HungerMitao. HungerMitao and everybody who gets associated with HungerMitao is basically evangelizing the need in our communities for people who are food challenged and the work of the food banks. It's basically connecting people with their local food banks. And so nothing that is donated goes to HungerMitao. I just wanted to clarify that because I feel that's really important. And why is it important to engage? You know, I'm not on the employment rolls of any food bank, so I can say this honestly. Two people of the Indian American community, we have scaled every height. We are amazing professionals. We lead industries. We lead our professional careers. I mean, we are in politics. We are spelling bee champions. Year after year after year. We are not very visible in civic engagement yet. And we've got to change that. This is the country we have made home. And we need to make sure we are visible when it comes to volunteering, when it comes to fighting hunger. I mean, this is such a basic need. And everybody from the Indian community knows that feeding the hungry is just part of our DNA. Now, why is unifying important? Because if we don't unify, you could be writing a check to Tarrant Area Food Bank, I could be writing my check, Ritu's doing her thing, Raj is doing his thing, but the numbers don't add up enough for us to really paint a picture. Now, because we are unifying, we are able to boldly claim this, that the HungerMitao movement has enabled more than 35 million meals through the Feeding America network. The movement currently, it started with North Texas Food Bank. It went to Houston, to New York City, to Atlanta, Seattle, 10 days before COVID last year. And today we are launching at the Tarantaria Food Bank. It's a momentous occasion for us. It shows how the community is getting behind it. 35 million meals enabled was not Raj and I, right? We are standing on the shoulders of a tremendously compassionate community who, as soon as they found out that hunger truly is an issue here, are rolling up their sleeves and getting involved. Just a mind-boggling statistic, almost 50 million people in the US are food challenged. So we are very proud of the 35 million meals milestone, but we've just only begun. And so I'm happy to invite all of you to this launch today. And we have a few other launches scheduled later this year, but we will share information about those as we get closer to the time. Raj?
Anna, you want to talk about the four pillars?
Sure, thank you. Okay. So this is how people can engage. There's a way that every one of us, even young children, can engage. The first thing is we need to be aware. How are we becoming aware? Today, all of you are hearing about this. Go talk to 10 other friends about this. Tell them that hunger is an issue in our neighborhoods. There are children who are going to school who are hungry, and it's really not acceptable. Invite us. If you're having a gathering, we're happy to come take 5 minutes to talk to your friends about how they can engage. And none of this will be a fundraiser. It's basically an awareness session. So that is one of the ways you can help. Volunteering. The food banks depend on volunteers, because if they had to pay people to do the work that our volunteers are doing, then the statistics of a dollar to five meals would have been very different. Third way, let's do food drives. You know, we can all collect food. We have so many events at our homes. What Raj and I have done for the last 4 years is anytime there's an event at our home, whether it's a Christmas party, a Diwali party, a religious event, anything, we ask people to bring a jar of peanut butter that can then be donated to the food bank. It does two things. It collects food for the food bank, but it also opens up a conversation. People will ask, why are you collecting food bank? And gives you a way in to speak about why. The fourth, very important, is donations. Money is what the food bank needs to make sure that the food they are distributing is a balanced meal. You know, because donations can sometimes leave gaps. The food bank may fall short on protein and they have to go out and source it. They have to pay gas for the trucks that are distributing the food, because obviously hungry people don't come to the food bank to get food, they go to the pantries. So the food bank has to get the food from the distribution center to the pantries. So those are the four ways. And like I said, I mean, if somebody doesn't feel like they are in a space where they can donate money, come volunteer. Let's become visible. So everybody has a way to engage, and I invite you to come join in whatever way you can. Multiple ways, perhaps.
Great.
Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Anna. It is a great insight that you have given to our audience about HungerMitao. It will not be important to recap, but few things I do want to share. As Anna mentioned, it is not an organization. It is a movement to engage a community with a food bank that is doing such an excellent job, right? Where else can you get five meals for a dollar? Where else will you find an organization where 94 cents of every dollar that you donate goes right to the cause, right? Very little overhead, much very effective organization. And also, as Anna mentioned, you know, these four impact pillars that's on the screen right now, I wanted to kind of share with you something. There is a guru in India. Anna and I heard his discourse a decade ago. And three words that he said in his discourse stuck with us. And those three words he said that human life is best lived through three stages. And they are learning, earning, and returning. And we believe these four impact pillars that Anna mentioned allows everyone, regardless of whichever stage they are in, to get connected, to show their empathy, to show their compassion to fellow human beings. If you are in a learning stage, come out and volunteer, raise awareness. We understand you cannot give money, but can you give your voice? If you are in your earning phase and you are saving money for the home and for your children's education, that's exactly where your priority should be. And you cannot donate too much to the food bank, that's okay. But how about a food drive, that extra can of beans that's been sitting there in your pantry? How about donating that? Make sure it's not expired, right? And there are ways that everyone can get engaged. In fact, I liked one statement that Anna mentioned, which is these four impact pillars takes the crutches away. No one has an excuse that, oh, I cannot join now. Yes, you can. Yes, you can make a difference. And in that regards, I want to invite you all to consider joining a limited time and first of its kind, what we are calling HungerMitao Tarrant Founders Circle. And what it is, I'll explain to you in a couple of slides here. But basically, we believe that this is a community engagement, not a Raj and Anna engagement, right? And we are inviting the community to be known as founders of the Tarrant Area Food Bank, HungerMitao, right? Now, how can you become a founder? And this, by the way, becoming a founder, once you are a founder in perpetuity, you will be known as you were one of those early engager person who are our company who got involved and helped launch the HungerMitao movement in the Tarrant area for the Tarrant area food bank. It's also a legacy opportunity. So as I mentioned, here are some of the benefits and expectations for becoming a founder circle member. You know, perpetual namesake recognition. Always you'll be known as part of the founder circle. You will have obviously invitation to HungerMitao Tarrant events. You will be known and you will be a HungerMitao ambassador, right? Please don't look at it as a task. Don't look at it as a job. This is the right thing to do for a fellow human being. We encourage you to be the spokesperson. We encourage you to conduct awareness session. Get everybody else who is, just bluntly speaking, ignorant about the hunger issue that's right here in our front yard and backyard. Let's help raise awareness, right? Let's not push them to donate. No, that's not the point here. Raise awareness and they will click depending on what stage of life they are in. So here is how you can join and be part of the founder circle. It's our goal as HungerMitao, the Indian American community team, to enable a million meals for Tarrant Area Food Bank. How about an applause, guys? Come on, let's do it. We can make it happen, right? And the way to do that, we don't believe, the beauty about the HungerMitao model is that we don't believe in one and done. As Anna mentioned, we just don't want to write checks and be done with. No, we want to be seen as a community that is caring, passionate, and engaged. And this is our engagement model. We invite you to join any one of these circles, engagement circles, right? The bronze circle, for example. Step up and say that 10,000 meals is what I will commit to. And by the way, when you do the math, it's no more than a Starbucks coffee a week, not even a day, a week. You give up one Starbucks a coffee and you are enabling 10,000 meals over a course of 3 years. And we want you to give your funding over 3 years because we want your engagement more than your dollars, my friends. So please consider joining any one of these circles and help us get to the first million meal. In interest of time, I'm not showing you another slide, but I will quickly talk about it though. Bronze Circle 10,000 meals. If you give up a coffee a week, you are able to achieve that. Silver Circle 25,000 meals. Give up a coffee a day and you are able to achieve that. Right? $1,600 over per year, over 3 years. Right? When you break it down, you know, it's not that much. Right? In fact, I'm kind of bringing from my memory, the first three circles are under $1 a day, and you are able to achieve almost up to 50,000 meals, close to $1 at 50,000 meals. Diamond Circle, 75,000 meals, $5,000 per year. And let me give you a simple example. There is a group here in North Texas, and they call themselves Friends Against Hunger, right? They said, we want to make an, they vacation together, this children go to school together, right? And they do things together, about 10 or 12 families. And they say, you know what? Individually, we may be able to do Bronze Circle, but collectively, we can hit bigger number. And the Friends Against Hunger, they committed to Gold, 50,000 meals. And they have enabled, I think, Johnny, if I'm not mistaken, they have enabled almost 100,000 meals, are getting close to that, right? So if a group of you want to come together and say, hey, we want this group to be known as part of the Founder Circle, and we will commit to 100,000 meals, great, come on over, right? Whatever entity you want to be recognized as part of the Founder Circle, and whatever circle you come in at, you're welcome. You know, it's my dad used to say, you know, it takes drops of water to eventually become an ocean. It takes grains of sand to eventually become the vast desert. But so we need everyone from every circle. So please consider joining one of these circles today. If you need to think about it, shall I really give up my Starbucks coffee? All right, think about it. But here's one thing you could do. And please, we, as I said, money is the last thing on our four impact pillars. So this is no pressure. But if you are interested to learn more about this, want to have a conversation with Ritu, myself, Stephen, Lisa, Julie, you know, just in the chat box, just say, hey, I'm interested in a circle. That's it. And maybe send us an email, put your email there or your name there. We'll get back to you. And we'll have a conversation. And that's what I want to make sure. It's a conversation, not a hard press. You got to buy this timeshare right now before the deal goes away. No, nothing like that. It's going to be wonderful. And frankly speaking, this is the first step in our journey. I am convinced that we, the Indian American community, will raise millions and millions of meals for Tarrant Area Food Bank. You know, we commit to that. In fact, in that spirit, if it's okay with you and not to look arrogant, Anna and I, Anna, would you please come here? Anna and I would like to commit to 100,000 meals for Tarrant Area Food Bank.
Sure. And Raj, we're also getting in the chat session, we have interested people.
Okay.
So Kamal, and Prakash, we will get back with you.
Fantastic.
Talk to you.
Please.
Thank you.
Please keep putting your names there, and we would love to share, you know, your name if you would like to. And really, end of the day, unless we collaborate, we will not be able to make a difference, right? Together, we can move mountains. Individually, we will have a hard time scaling a mountain. So let's work together, folks. So this is a unique opportunity.
Ritu is part
okay.
of the founders.
Ritu is fantastic. How do you like that animation? Great. So circle members, so just to recap this one, you know, those who will help us reach the first million meals by joining one of the circles, will we welcome them to be part of the HungerMitao Tarrant Area Food Bank Founder Circle. And Julie, if I may request, maybe we can even on some wall at the food bank, we could actually put aside where we can actually have the pictures, our names, or something of that nature. We can work on that. That would be wonderful.
Absolutely.
Excellent, excellent. Great. So with that, friends, please keep that chat session active. We'd like to continue to get your names. And I'm very, very excited to introduce our next speaker. You know, as Anna mentioned, we have launched HungerMitao at 5 food banks. And every food bank, every launch, we learn a few lessons, right? One of the lessons that we learn, and Stephen, I think it's a good thing that we waited till now, because this is a perfect launch. Because in the past, we launched and then we went looking for folks who were interested to be ambassador. You know, we don't have titles, a org chart for HungerMitao is a movement, but we do need point person, and we call them co-chairs. So we are excited that we are launching this with a co-chair already in place, a person who is just as passionate about giving back as Anna and I and others in the community. We met Ritu Raju about a month ago. Our good friend Suvarna Kati, who is on the session here today, her husband actually introduced us to Ritu Raju, and after that, things took off. And we met up with Ritu and Stephen in Fort Worth a month ago, and her energy, the entire drive back from Fort Worth to Dallas. Ritu, I want to tell you, Anna and I kept beaming. We said, wow, we have a fantastic leader who is going to do wonderful at Tarrant area, and a great person to work with. And without any delay, I would introduce and welcome Ritu to please unmute yourself and say a few words to the participants.
Thank you so much for that very sweet introduction. So in 2019, a young man, a 23-year-old quarterback named Joe Burrow, was awarded the Heisman Trophy, which is given to the most outstanding player in college football. In his acceptance speech, Joe devoted 31 seconds to talk about hunger and poverty in his hometown of Athens, Ohio, a small town in Southeast Ohio. Those 31 seconds had a reverberating impact. People all over the world donated money. They set up GoFundMe pages, Facebook fundraisers. Within days, the Athens Food Bank raised enough money and food to feed its entire population through the duration of the pandemic. I share this story. I will never be a quarterback. I will certainly never be 23 again. But I share this story to share the collective impact, the power of collective impact. Raj and Anna, thank you so much for your generous, gracious donation of 1 million meals. I will not be able to match that, but I know that whatever I give, with the power of that collective impact, we can all together make a positive impact on the work of the food bank. You know, hunger is universal. From my work in the community college landscape for the last 2 decades, I can share with you that over 50% of community college students and 47% of four-year college students have experienced food insecurity, which is another term for hunger. We were shocked when we found out that even faculty, 25% of our part-time faculty reported having experienced food insecurity at various times in their lives. Hunger is real, and hunger pervades all sections of society. When public schools shut down during the onset of COVID, the biggest fear and worry that educators like me all over the nation had was about our public school children. Many children, an overwhelming majority of children in the K-12 education system, depend on the food they get at school. For many of them, the 2 meals that they eat at school are the only meals that they eat, period. You know, I'm sure all of you have heard the term hangry. Hangry is a mashup of hunger and angry. You know, sometimes we wonder, why are there so many angry people in the world? I assure you that many of them are hungry. Hunger is real. I sincerely appeal to you to join us in this war against hunger. When I visited the TAFB, the statistic that jumped out at me immediately was that $1 can provide 5 meals, just $1. Your contribution through the power of collective impact can make a huge difference to our community. Your contribution will ensure that no child, no parent, no elder goes to bed hungry tonight or any night. Would you please take that first step in the fight against hunger with us today? Thank you so much for your generosity and support. Just that $1, that first dollar that will provide those 5 meals. Please make that first step with us today on the eve of Independence Day. Let's work together, and together we can win this battle. Let's hunger Mitao.
Love it. Love it, Ritu. Fantastic, Ritu. Now you know why we are so excited to have Ritu at Tarrant Area. Ritu, under your guidance, under your heart, and I use the word leadership, but frankly, as we, you and I and Anna have spoken, everybody who is part of this movement is a leader. You know, in fact, the way we work in Hunger Mitao is that we have 2 co-chairs, so there's backup to each other. And then we also have what we call our steering council. And we invite those who would like to not just write a check, not just be part of the founder circle, not just volunteer, but want to also give their voice and their ideas. Please join Ritu and us and be part of the Tarrant Area Steering Council. Here in North Texas Food Bank, where Hunger Mitao started, we have a very vibrant steering council. In fact, several members are here to support our brothers and sisters in Tarrant Area. So to work with Ritu, I think it'll be fun, number one. And number two, you know, I think a team that can come together, you know, and it is so much fun. If you can give up just 1 hour a week, and it's not like a clockwork, like, you know, this time you may only need 30 minutes, this one, and 1 hour and a half next one. But if you can set aside 1 hour to help those in need, those who are food challenged, children, seniors, veterans, this is, join this, you know, drop a note to us and we can work together. With that, I'm going to invite the lady who I was appreciating at the very beginning, who has been an anchor, a quarterback to us, and amazing force. And Julie, I think I can't tell you how lucky you are to have folks like Stephen and Lisa as part of the team. I want to also share one thing before I hand it over to Lisa. Once Stephen introduced us to Lisa, we invited them to a launch we had here in North Texas Food Bank. And I'm going to take a minute more to say that this model of Hunger Mitao has now been replicated by the Chinese American community. And we had a joint volunteer session. I invited them and Lisa came over. She drove from Fort Worth she wanted to understand exactly what is Hunger Mitao, how do they work, meet the people. So it took time on a Saturday to come out, visit, spend time, and get to know people. I think that shows commitment. So without further delay, Lisa, over to you. Tell us a little bit about Tarrant Area, your role. It's your minute.
Awesome. Thank you so much for that introduction. And thank you so much to everyone who's spoken so far. I think we've gotten a great introduction to the food bank from Julie and Stephen, and then also our relationship with Hunger Mitao so far. I just wanted to briefly jump on and introduce myself. I don't have a whole lot of stuff to say, but I wanted to, if we can hop to the next slide, talk to you and let you know that I'll be reaching out in the future to get everyone involved. I want to have some more, some volunteer days and some tours where we can maybe have a smaller gathering. I know we canceled today so that, or we moved virtual today so that we wouldn't be in danger from that Delta variant. But I think with smaller tours and smaller volunteer opportunities, we'll get everybody out. We'd love to see you guys in person as well. So I'll be following up. Oh, Ritu's gonna bring me some samosas in the chat. Thank you. We missed out on some samosas today, you guys. I had those ordered and all ready for our launch. So we're definitely gonna have to meet in person for those. I want to let you guys know that I'll be following up in the coming weeks to gauge some interest if you'd be interested in coming by for a tour or a different opportunity. So just keep an eye out and thank you so much for having me. I'll turn it back to Raj, I think.
Yes, wonderful. Lisa, thank you very much. I appreciate you offering folks to connect with you, to come and see HungerMitao and a Tarrant Area Food Bank in action together. So I highly encourage those of you who have not visited the food bank to take an hour or two, come go over there and you will leave more informed, a lot more inspired of how, with a little effort, we can make tens of thousands of meals possible for those who are in need and those who kind of depend on us. So with that, I guess maybe this is a good time, Lisa, if you think we can try to play that video again. The short, let me try it out and see if it works. How is that?
Better.
Latapatta latapatta kamara kamini adhara ragini ho. Latapatta latapatta kamara kamini adhara ragini mere dar aaye kaise saj dhaj dekho mere piya ki saari jiya se baari mere angna mein dekho aaj khila hai chaand.
Excellent. I hope you enjoyed it. Great. Let me just make sure. All right, great. So first of all, this group, they call themselves Virtual Arts for Humanity. And hang on one quick second. Let me see how I can get the spotlights taken care of. Bear with me, folks. Okay. Great. Okay. So this group connected with us during the pandemic time, and they say, how can we help HungerMitao? We heard about you. How can we help? So we basically said, well, you know, there are many ways to help. We are trying to raise awareness within the community. And they said, well, we do these dances and we do singing. So how can we join forces? And we also want to help feed the hungry. So I said, well, it's a match made in heaven. Whenever we have programs like this, can you create a small module like this? And sure enough, in the middle of the pandemic, these kids got together and they made, you know, with social distancing, etc., they made few clips for us, which we use, and this is one of them. The young lady is Varsha Vasu, and she has already enabled tens of thousands of meals for Feeding America by conducting these virtual concerts and so on. So clearly, people are finding multiple ways. There is a young person in Houston, 10th grader. He, during his visits to India with his parents, he found out, you know, the recipes that his grandma, because he always felt that the food back there was more delicious than food over here, you know. And he asked his grandmother, do you have the recipe? She said, no, son, I don't have any recipes. I just throw a little bit of this and a little bit of that. So he said, well, I'm going to follow you around and I'll capture that recipe so we can keep that recipe in the family. He put a recipe book together. And then he was encouraged to actually sell that book. So he started selling those books. And they said, okay, which cause do you want to give to? He said, I want to give to Feeding America through HungerMitao. And guess what? This young 10th grader has a book that he has published over Amazon with 100% of proceeds going to Feeding America. So there are kids, adults, working class people, everybody finding different ways through which they can help their hungry neighbors. So friends, I know we are running a little bit over time here. What we will do is this, the link to the video clips, that two very good, powerful video clips from Tarrant Area Food Bank, we will send that to you in an email. Few of you also asked for, can we have access to the PowerPoint deck? Sure you can. Nothing here is proprietary. Everything is open share. We'll be happy to do that. So we will share a link to that PowerPoint presentation that Julie has shared with you. Anything else you need from us, any inquiry, any questions, you know, please do not hesitate. This is the first step that we have taken on this journey of making sure no one goes hungry. Madhuban Group has been amazing in their support. In fact, they were going to bring a team of 15 people to come out and volunteer today. Tara, I'm sorry we could not do the in-person volunteering, but I know that your group will continue to remain engaged and you will help us spread the word. So if my one final call to all of you, Zoom sessions are kind of funny. You don't know, is it success, not success? We always felt, because we conducted hundreds of awareness sessions, it just takes one person sometimes who just says, I get it. And then they become the tip of the spear to get the word out. So we hope you are that one person. We hope you will help us spread the word and you know, help Tarrant Area Food Bank. We hope in all sincerity that this virus is behind us soon and we can get back to a new norm that is better than before, a new norm that unites us, a new norm that doesn't, you know, allow us to stay on the sideline. In fact, this may be a realization. We were so consumed living our lives within ourselves. You know, we are hoping that this will be moving from a me generation to an us generation. With that, I conclude my remarks. Julie, Stephen, everyone else, anybody can unmute, speak before we wrap up. If you're interested in one more Bollywood medley, I would need at least 5 show of hands before I play that, because I don't want to take your Saturday afternoon away. Okay, I got 1 here, 2, 3. Oh, wow, well, now they're all clicking. Wonderful. So as I'm queuing this up, anybody wants to speak, please just jump right in and share your thoughts, reflection. The Zoom floor is yours, my friend.
Raj, I have a dance challenge that was issued by Rutu that the next time we're all together in person, she and I would be facilitating the Bollywood dance.
Awesome.
A thumbs up.
Got it.
A thumbs up from the group for that.
Well, actually, Julie, I did not tell you, Trisha Cunningham here, the CEO of North Texas Food Bank. Mm-hmm. You have to see her Bollywood dance. She is amazing.
I hear a challenge.
We may have a dance off, just like Stephen wants a cricket match. So we are going to actually have a NTFB cricket team and a TAFB cricket team, both, of course, HungerMitao banners, and we will play it. We'll raise money for HungerMitao. Stephen.
I love it. Let's do it. Raj, I want to say on behalf of Tierran Area Food Bank, thank you so much for your vision and for your leadership, both you and Anna, that you've taken something very local and you've made it a national movement for Feeding America and the network of food banks. We are grateful for your vision, your leadership, and your heart. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm going to just...
Raj and Anna, and thank you to the TAFB for welcoming me with open arms. This is an exciting beginning, and, you know, I'm so honored to be part of this. Thank you.
Can't think of a better person than you, Ritu. I mean, everyone who has heard Ritu can see. I mean, Dr. Ritu, she is so passionate about this thing and so knowledgeable, so articulate. You know, and that's the kind of leader we need out there.
And she also has a very unique view into the student population, that's because right. We never think about, you know, we think, okay, students who are going to college obviously have money to go to college, but hunger is such an issue there. So I'm really grateful that Ritu brings that that view into the HungerMitao group, because I think our community needs to know that.
Great. So I'm going to play
this. I had a quick comment to make, if that's okay.
Go right ahead. The floor is open.
All right, everyone. Hi, my name is Vijay Asava. As you can imagine, I'm Raj's oldest son. And I've had the privilege of being on the ground floor, looking outside the window, watching both of my parents be involved in getting the ball rolling and started on this. And I think being involved in not only the North Texas Food Bank's launch of HungerMitao, but then seeing the subsequent launches across the nation, whether it's New York, Austin, Seattle, et cetera, it's a snowball effect. And so looking today, I know we probably would have had quite a few more people show up in person, but seeing the amount of attendees and the participation just goes to show the staying power of the movement. And, you know, end of the day, fact of the matter is this, people can donate and be philanthropic in many different ways. They may choose to target education. They may choose to target other things. But one thing my dad always says is, how can a kid learn on an empty stomach? How can someone be successful if they're hungry? So hunger is really, I think, one of the foundational challenges that if we can help eradicate, can probably have a downstream impact on many of the other areas where people are philanthropic. So $1 turning into 5 meals is a pretty powerful thing. And very excited to see all of you guys be part of this and seeing the Tarrant area join, because I always think of Dallas as Dallas-Fort Worth. It is the Metroplex. We are one of the largest areas and Metroplexes in the country. And our brand of HungerMitao here in DFW should represent that as well. So I think we've gotten off to a great start here. and look forward to coming out to the Tarrant Area Food Bank, volunteering with my wife and family, and continuing to see the HungerMitao brand spread here in Texas. So
great
to meet all you guys. Thank you so much.
Not just your wife and family, Vijay, try to bring your friend circle, your connection. We want your generation to be more engaged. End of the day, you guys are our future. So don't limit yourself to just that. So bring as many folks as you can and make awareness a key part of what you do. So thank you. Thank you very much, everyone. We have a few more clips like this, but again, we don't want to take your Saturday afternoon away from you. If you're interested, I will include a link to some of these wonderful performances by this young group. And we just found out Ritu is originally from Houston. And we just found out that Ritu knows these artists well. That is interesting. Talk about small world. So this is great. I would love to now thank everybody for giving us your time, giving us your heart, right? And helping us launch this movement on the right foot. So with that, Lisa, I'm going to turn it over to you. Any wrap-up thing in regard to logistics? Do we have everybody's email? Because I don't want to just turn it off and then wonder, you know, do we have their emails or not? So if you have not RSVP directly to Lisa, I would request that in the chat session, drop in your email. So that your name and email. So Lisa will have that. She will make sure you get the presentation and the material that we promised you.
Yeah, I think I'm recognizing most of the names that are here right now as having RSVP'd and been chatting with me on email. So thank you guys so much for doing that. And we will be sure to follow up. Thank you guys.
Thank you.
All right, enjoy your Saturday. It's storming where I am. Anybody else?
It is storming here also. It is, yeah, it is pouring.
It's gonna be a cozy one. Just kind of hang out at home and we'll see you later on.
So in India, they say this is the weather for chai and pakoras.
Samosas.
Chai and samosas. So it's masala chai and samosa time. And you know what? I think this is an intervention by somebody up there. We could have all been over there driving in this weather, right? Mm-hmm. And who knows, maybe hail or whatnot. They wanted to keep us safe because they want us to help support this thing for a long time. So, all right, folks, thank you very much. Thanks for putting up with me. If there was an oversight, an error on my side, I sincerely apologize. Thank you.
Bye.
Take care. Bye.